Recording. Hey, hi, hello. How's it going? How you doing? No clap today. Happy Sunday, because this is when the recording goes out. It's on Sunday. I am fixing my monitor and my camera, so the camera looks good and the monitor is not too shifted. It doesn't matter to you guys. You don't care. You're just here for the footballs. Yeah, we're going to get to it. Let me get rid of this. It is week 8 here in our Madden season. Let's check out who we're playing this week. So we are playing nobody. So we are 4-3, and I still have fast forward on, so let's get through our bye week. Bye week time. So it's actually week 9 and week 10. Okay. We are facing the Detroit Lions again. This is the second time we have faced them. Let me take off fast forward. Let's check our stuff. Check the positional breakdown. Lee Bodden cuts our corner. Lee Bodden, keep Roy Williams out of the end zone. Ernie Sims is a great outside linebacker. All right. Let's check out the quarterback. John Kitna. Kevin Jones is the halfback. John Bradley, fullback. Dan Campbell is the tight end. Downside of his career. Okay. Roy Williams, wide receiver number 1. Calvin Johnson, wide receiver number 2. Jeff Backus is the left tackle. Manuel Ramirez is the left guard. Center, Dominic Raiola. Steven Peterman is the right guard. Goster Cherilis is the right tackle. Corey Redding is the D tackle, along with Sean Cody. Jared DeVries and Dwayne White are the ends. Left outside linebacker is Alex Lewis. Right outside linebacker is Pro Bowler Ernie Sims. Middle linebacker is Paris Lennon. Lee Bodden, Brian Kelly, Daniel Bullocks, and Dwight Smith are the defensive backfield. Jason Hansen is the kicker, and Nick Harris is the punter. Before we get into our game, let's check out the injury report and our depth chart to make sure that we don't have to change nothing. All right, we are down to Michael Okowu, who will be back next week to back up left outside linebacker. Let's check our depth chart to make sure we put Grossman in. All right, we are ready to play the Detroit Lions. Woo! All right. So as of this recording, Shane Waldron was fired in IRL Chicago Bears land, which, you know, after watching the New England game, that's not exactly what I would have wanted. I would have wanted to see, you know, Eberflus and Waldron go. So, but we made some kind of a change. So I guess that's going to have to do.
Welcome to Chicago's beautiful lakefront area, where today's game will
take
place.
There. Just past the turn that down a little bit.
Game looks like it should
it's
be
down
a
to 60%.
Two very well.
All right. Sorry, Al Michaels. Also, bless up to Ben Herbstreit, the Golden Retriever. He's missed already. All right,
kickoff, so
Devin Hester taking the kick.
Hansen,
here we are. We are second place, trying to get to first place. If we win this game, we have a good shot at getting there because we did defeat Minnesota last time. Whoa.
Number 23.
40% CPU usage.
To the 35. The Bears.
Holy cannoli.
Rex Grossman will step in as the starter. Number 22, the lone back. Hand off to the tailback. Fuses. Number 53 comes up to make the play. At the 36.
Mixon runs with passes.
All right, I have to check. Let me do something real quick. Let me see what's using our CPU. See, OBS is using a lot of it. Huh. Interesting. All right, so we're doing that.
Drops back, closing in, throwing.
Go Booker.
He hits his receiver.
There we go.
At the 46.
I think it's the recording that's doing
that. That pass in the air and picks up a first down.
Well, you look for the open guy in any play, but there is a progression. You look to your first guy, then your second, and so on.
All right, we're going to go Michael Bennett to Matt Forte here.
Only one man in the backfield. Going to the air on first down. On the move.
Oh, fuck.
The Lions grab the
shit.
Ball.
No.
The 30. The 20.
Oh, Paris Lennon gets a fumble return.
Costly fumble, and it's a touchdown. Perfect place at the right time on that play. A fumble recovery and
damn
a
it
touchdown. Hanson comes in for the extra point. The extra point attempt is good.
They're going to try and force more turnovers. The offense should be aware that they're going to be going for the strip and may be able to take advantage of their aggressive play.
I think there was a thing that helps reduce some usage. I saw about setting your camera as a scene and just porting that scene over. Yeah. So maybe I'll try something different for
picking up a loose ball and returning it for a touchdown.
Let's go halfback lead. Let's go back to the run. We were doing okay with the pass. That's just one of those things where I try to use the highlight stick. I tried to use the highlight stick with Greg Olsen, and yeah, that's kind of how we ended up with that. Because if you use it and it doesn't work, you're like really susceptible to fumbles.
It's rid of it, and this pass is completed. The 40. Kelly comes up to make the play at the 27-yard line. He's very dangerous, John, after he has the ball.
He's one of those guys.
Try this pin deep play.
Really,
I don't know. I'm feeling confident. Oh, they're coming out in this bullshit.
To make the catch if he can get to it. But what makes him really special is what he does once he gets it in his hand.
Oh, no.
Air under this one, looking for his man deep.
I should have tried to, like, angle
down
it somewhere.
Couldn't get it to his target.
I should have tried to angle it more. More towards middle of the field, I think that would have been fine.
The Bears come out of the bunch formation. Hand it off to the back. DeVries is there for the tackle at the 25.
One thing these guys don't want to do is give up in a running game. Because if they do that, they become one-dimensional. And that plays right into the defense's hand.
Play action flow. This is what we're looking at.
The Lions come out of the nickel package.
They're showing man here. I don't know what we're doing.
It's the call. Setting up play action. Throwing. Brian Kelly picks it off.
Got another one.
Great play. Great execution. Now that's what defense is all about.
I don't know what our coverage is going to be here, because I guess I'm more worried about the pass than I am with their run.
The Bears line up in a 4-3. He'll pass on first down. Gets the pass off. Knocked down.
What the defense is doing is
always great when they get an interception.
They're in position so that whatever
happens,
the ball is
in front. And we don't. It's always fun. Always super fun to see.
Second and 10. Ball on the 26-yard line.
One back. Everything you got. On the 10.
We also have our lacquer back, so maybe that'll.
With the throw. And he hits his target. Manning is there for the tackle at the 35. He found a soft spot in the coverage, John.
The receiver did a great job reading the coverage. He found a hole in the zone, and the quarterback found him in that hole with the pass.
Chicago goes with a four-man front, receives the handoff, gets the pass off.
Nice.
This one falls.
Pressured him,
so he manages,
and he made a bad throw.
Heavy pressure, but the incompletion still brings up fourth down.
The line did a good job protecting him long
enough
to get that one off. They definitely didn't want to take a sack in that situation.
Good defensive stand there. Now they'll punt it away after a three and out. Fair catch.
All right.
Now it's their turn to do something on offense. They're down by a touchdown early. But these guys have the kind of offense that can score any time they have the ball.
It's a good sign. We got our first offensive or first defensive stop.
Troy comes out in a 4-3. Hand off to the tailback. Smith comes up to make the play at the 49-yard line.
You can't have a good running attack without blocking. But blocking alone won't get you what you need. You got to have a back who can find the holes when they're there.
Number 22 lines up behind his fullback in the eye. Throwing. Right on target to the wide receiver. Lewis is there.
I'm just going to kind of like cover. Going to kind of like protect when we get to
putting some heat on your throat. This guy really let it go.
When we get to that, those kind of situations. I'm kind of looking like fullback.
Play action. Rolls right. Looking for a long completion. Aggressive play calling that time, but now it's second down. Second and 10. The Lions with a four-man front. He hands it off.
Bullock
is there for the tackle at the 22-yard line. And he was able to create a lot of space on that run, John.
Well, it started with some good blocking. And when he got through there, he turned upfield, and they weren't in position to tackle him.
Hand off to the tailback. Nice play fake. Getting some air under this one, looking for his man deep. Touchdown, Bears.
Easy. Bye, Greg. Easy clap.
Weakness in the defense and makes them pay.
Jeez, 10-mile-an-hour wind. That's going to be very helpful on the fourth.
Which will knot it up. The extra point attempt is good.
All right. So after two turnovers, we finally get into the end zone. See if we can do okay with our, oh yeah. We're not going to have to worry about them returning it on this side
this
of the field.
This one is taken by Kaysen. They forced a 3-and-out on the last series.
I think we just got to come out with extra defensive backs. Because I think protecting the pass is going to be more of an issue for us than...
Only one man back. They'll pass on first down. With the pass ball's incomplete.
Yeah, I think protecting against the pass is going to be more important than...
Before he could make the reception.
Yeah, and he's either going to get in there and knock the ball out, or he's going to knock someone else out.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
Yeah, and I don't know. We're kind of finding some success here.
Only one man in the backfield. With the throw. This pass is incomplete. Got just a little too much air under it.
The intended receiver on the play.
Hold on. All right. I wasn't expecting you to package, so that's all that was. All right, we're just going to go back to sync. I think that's what we did last time, but just flip the play just so we have,
Kipna will work out of the shotgun. Pressure coming. Fires this one deep. He made it. Brown is there on the stop. He brings it in for a big game.
Almost every wide receiver. I think that's what happened.
Running routes as they get older.
I don't think that's a good thing to go with. Because I think that's what happened is they had a missed catch.
Making some changes along the defensive front. A little misdirection. Urlacher is there for the tackle at the 37-yard line.
Running the ball consistently is a first step in creating a balanced attack.
So that's play goes
man
for
here.
About
37-yard line.
What screen? They saw play two quarters.
Dropping back, gets the pass off.
Oh, Charles Tillman taking it away. Nice.
Good idea to check off to some kind of run play at the line. You just can't force passes into coverage like that.
The offense gets ready to go following the interception.
Nothing. They don't get
nothing. A little misdirection. Stopped him for his third tackle.
Mickey
so
just
far.
Stopped
yeah,
running.
Good balance of run and pass on offense. The defense doesn't have a chance to focus in on either one of them.
They need to be a little Olsen option here. So we got Forte, who's going to go out for a streak. And we kind of have Olsen there for a check down. No one's with him.
Throwing. He finds his man. The 30, the 20, the 10. Dives, touchdown.
No one went with him. So that's the easiest touchdown you're going to see. You just need to let him get a few yards downfield and just fire it to him. Bink. Can make the best play in the ball. Couldn't ask for it any easier than that.
The point after is good. Now they've put it together offensively with 14 unanswered points.
They have a lot of talent on the offensive side of the ball. Scoring runs like this aren't all that unusual.
That's pretty good. Oh, that's right.
This one is handled by Kasem.
You know that the offense has their eyes set on tying this thing up here on this drive. We'll have to see what they're able to put together.
I'm probably going to be in dime 3-2-6 for most of this game just because I think that gives me enough coverage against the run and pass. Because we have like three linebackers in there to try and pinch the defensive line to protect against the run.
Give it to the halfback. They'll go with a play fake. Going deep. Incomplete.
Looking for Calvin missed down, but the pass off that the one. Let's just bring pressure here, I guess.
Defensive line shifting around a bit. They line up in the I formation. He gets the carry. Nice play fake. Gets rid of it. Chelmer comes up to make the play. He recognizes the blitz and gets the ball out for a first down.
Yeah, and he saw a good matchup.
Okay.
He made
all right, I guess we'll allow that. Let's try two man under. Two man's got us the interception. Plus, I think that kind of protects us a little bit better against some deep balls. Because I can kind of be back there. Oh, Lance Briggs with an interception off the deflection. Let's go. I'll take that one.
And the defense makes a great play on the ball and beats your receiver to it.
They line up in the I formation. Gives the ball off.
Oh, if only I could have gotten past him.
As a coach, you need to make sure that you establish your running game as a weapon.
I'm going to go Olsen option again, but this time I'm going to look straight to Hester instead. I'm going to ignore whatever Forte does. They caught up ground on the completion.
When you have guys with speed that can get
a blast, we'll run it to the left side.
It all begins with the offensive line. Because they're going to have to hold their blocks a little longer because it takes more time for the play to develop.
And he gets in there. Touchdown.
And he powers his
the boys.
He follows that push and he gets the score.
Wow. All right. Scored three times in the first quarter.
Number nine comes in to attempt the point after. The point after is good. And a great finish to that drive as they got into the end zone, and the defense is going to have its hands full trying to keep them in check.
They're really executing out there. Seems like just about every call they make works to perfection. If the defense can
start.
Get them the ball back quickly here, they might be able to put this one away very early.
The kick sails out of the end zone. Their defense looking for a second straight interception.
All right. That's two interceptions on man coverage, so man might be working a little bit better today. It might be the play, so let's shade towards that. We got him pinched.
I'm
going to avoid getting pancaked.
Now they got to keep going at him. They can get that defense tired and on its heels. These games will get longer and bigger as the game goes on.
So that play goes try cover two. Six. So I'm going to have to defend against Calvin going deep. Let's flip that. So we have a cornerback over there. I hate that they do that. I hate that, like, the normal nickel coverage has the corner on an island where the offense never sets up like that. So, like, I always have to call this defense like this. Although we'll call it to the wide side of the field. But, like, yeah, they always set up like that, so it's such a tell.
Defensive line shifting around a bit. The Bears come out in a nickel package. On the call. Nice play fake. Gets the pass off. It was tipped.
I was a liability. I committed to the run there when it was a pass. Woo! I can't be doing that. I can't be doing that at all. Oh, it's only second down. I'm still kind of pinched.
There we go. Comes up to make the play at the 36-yard line. Jones manages a yard or two on the delay.
Try cover three. Again, we're going to have a clear as day tell. I think I just need to
pressure rolling. Wide receiver, number 92, is there on the stop.
Too many people in the middle of the field for that to get completed. Come on, boys.
And it's good for a first down.
Yeah, he excels on third down.
For him to get the first down on that, just a simple in-breaking route. Too many people on that side of the field, boys.
First and 10.
The Bears line up in a 4-3. Under pressure with the throw. The pass falls incomplete. He appeared to feel the pressure there.
So many passing attacks in the NFL rely on timing. When you can put pressure
cover
on the
two
passer,
this time.
You never give him a chance to get into a rhythm. And you force him to throw the ball before he wants to.
A pinch.
The Bears with a four-man front looking to run it here. Fakes the handoff. Throwing short. Complete to the wide receiver. Fumble. The Bears pick up the fumble. Good play by the defense to recover the fumbles.
Play action fullback flat.
Ball on the 34-yard line.
So we're going to look at Hester here. If it's not open, we're going to see if we can check it down to McKee. I think he's blitzing. Just going to try it. Bye, Devin.
Perfect throw against single coverage. Touchdown.
Ooh. I got that off at the perfect second, and that was the perfect throw. Hester had the defense beat. Tucked it in right inside. Oh, we're actually going to have to – they're actually going to get a return here. So despite the fact that we've kicked it four times.
And last drive tells me that the defense is in for a long day if they keep playing like this. They need to find a way to at least slow them down.
Sends it sailing.
Yep. Okay.
From the 8-yard line.
Decent.
The
decent.
Lions have their work cut out for them as they take over at the 25-yard line.
I think they're still going to mix some pass or some runs in here, but we can already start to just play some cloud coverage.
Jones, the lone back, looking upfield. Erlach is there on
okay, Mike Brown had to spend 17 seconds knocking over someone.
That'll be a first down.
He really ran well there. He gets some great blocks, and he has patience.
Yeah, I mean, I guess we'll be okay with them getting a decent run. You know, considering all everything.
Joe, the deep man. Great fake. Launching the pass deep down the right
side. Oh, that's caught.
Incomplete.
That's a touchdown if he catches that.
The guys up front got good pressure, forcing him to get rid of that one before he wanted to.
That's tough. They like to do kind of what we like to do as well. So it's like in passing situations or where I think they're passing, it might not hurt to just come out in two man.
shifting some personnel up front.
And
goes in motion. With the throw. Nearly intercepted.
Urlacher almost got the pick there.
He's a pretty good cover linebacker. He can run with most guys, and he gets good position. Then he reads the pass, and he makes his move. But he'll drop a few like that one.
I'd rather they just come out like this.
Chicago comes out with seven in the secondary. Drops back, gets rid of it.
I don't know what that play was. I have no idea what that play was. But we'll take it.
Coming now to punt it away. Graham back to return. From the 16-yard line.
Oh, that's fine.
And he's forced out of bounds at the 20. So they have first and 10 here.
Hey, if we get back to the 20, that's always a win for us.
Number 22 is the deep back. They give it to the halfback. Smith is there for the tackle at the 22-yard line.
They might not be busting off big games, but those linemen are really working hard down there.
Only one man in the backfield. Hand it off. Fumble. The Lions pick up the fumble. What a great strip.
If you can guess what happened, I went for the hit stick and didn't get it. I went for a highlight stick and didn't get it. And so we fumbled. You know, when we're up 28-7, we'll be okay with that happening.
Quarterback just let that one get away.
Johnson was the one they were trying to get the ball
God,
to.
God, stop. I want the 3-3-5. Fucking hell.
Second and 10. Ball on
the oh, yeah, I'm calling nickel coverage and I didn't flip the play.
Closing in with the throw and the catch is made.
Now this is where they really have to step up. If they are a better defense, and they're going to be the better defense, they have to show it right now.
Gain of two. Chicago lines up in a 4-3. Number 92 makes the stop, and they'll be
Hillemeyer. He took my tackle, so that was closer than it needed to be, but still.
You can see the kicker here.
This should be an easy make. If not, I'm gonna crank their fucking the slider all the way up. If he misses a 40-yard slightly to the left with 10-mile-an-hour wind behind him, get the fuck out of here.
The key to winning is having your drives get some sort of points for your team. They got it done on that drive. I'm sure they'll think a touchdown for their next one.
This one is handled by number 23.
They've got a pretty big lead here in the first half. So I'd expect to see him working the clock on this drive.
First ball on their own 20.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
Detroit goes with a four-man front on the carry. Smith is there on the stop at the 27-yard line.
He's shown good patience and vision in this one. I'm guessing if they're going to just keep
go ace tight end drag.
With the pass, gets his hand
up. He has a great feel for defending the pass. He always seems to be a great
position. I didn't really look anywhere else.
Playing the ball.
So.
Was his intended target.
So that's kind of what we get.
Detroit lines up in a 4-3. He's off to the tailback. Lewis is there for the tackle.
That's a good job of separating out of the defensive line.
He's coming right back with a boot to the left. So this is going to be an interesting play, especially with that.
The Lions line up in a 4-3. Nice play fake. With the throw, Sims comes up to make
the play. That was easy.
At the 41
yard line. The linebacker backed up immediately, so we knew we were going to have the edge pretty good there.
When you talk about selling a play fake, that's just the kind of thing they're talking about.
Stiff arms the defender to the ground. White is there on the stop at the 46-yard line.
You can't stop me. Let's go.
To carry it.
DeBreeze
comes up to make the play.
This team's always trying to get a good mix of run and pass plays.
5 yard gain.
Oh. Let's go boot slide. Hester's going to drag across the field the other way, but we're going to have Olsen, Booker, and McKee our way.
Fakes the handle. Going for the deep
man. You know, as a receiver, you have to be aware of so many things.
There is no way he was out of bounds. If he is out of bounds, throw the whole game away. Throw the whole game away.
Yeah, they might get this call reversed.
So as the referee looks at a few angles, we'll do the same. And now it all depends on what we can see, because the referee is going to see the same thing. I think it's a catch.
That's a tough call. Depends on what angle you're looking at it from.
Two, unless that never touches, but then both of his feet are there.
The player was inbounds when he caught the pass. It is a completed pass.
Thank you.
So the coach looks a lot smarter after getting the play reversed in his team's favor.
It didn't hurt that the official had some great replays to look at. They made it easy to overrule. 19-yard line.
They have a big, big lead. They're on the move again inside. Cody is there on the stop at the 18-yard line. The defensive tackle surged through the line to bring the runner down. And this is the ninth play of this drive. They're inside the 20.
Ooh, this could be a shot.
They'll go from the I formation. Hand it off to the back.
There we go.
Running with a lot of room in front.
Sam
comes up to make the play.
Was he already over 100?
Number 22 continues to run with authority, pounding it out.
Let's try the touchdown play.
At the three. They line up in the I formation.
Here we go. Everything you've got. Here we go. Watch the man.
Gives the ball off. Runs the ball.
No, couldn't get there.
Benson takes it up the middle for a yard or two. They need 2 yards to get it into the end zone.
One more, fella. Go make a play. Yes, sir. Yellow. 74.
With the carry. Touchdown.
I don't know how many touchdowns Benson has, so he can celebrate.
When it comes to a play like this, the lowest man with the best leverage is going to generate the biggest push. Seems that the offense got plenty low on that play.
All right, we're up 25.
Comes in to attempt the point after.
So offensively, we are running through them. Defensively, titmus, but we're doing all right.
He's a very tough runner to bring down. And when he gets those legs pumping and gets that kind of blocking, it signals a long drive for the defense.
From the 6 yard line.
Oh, I thought I made that tackle on the ground.
Possession into 3 points. Let's see what they do with the ball this time around.
All right, we can kind of play a little bit loosey-goosey. So if we want to start blitzing, we can.
Shifting some personnel up front.
He's going to shift to the wide side of the field.
Going to the air on first down. With the pass. And he hits his target. Going to the running back. They're able to pick up a first down. 15 yards gained
on the play. Should keep it easy and bring Briggs.
Keep the throttle down.
Slide towards. Okay. Didn't get the slide.
Gets the pass off. Drops the interception. He deflected it just in time to avert the completion.
Let's go saw zero. Second and 10. We're kind of playing, like I said, we're playing a little loosey-goosey here. Dre, we're going.
Okay.
The defense lines up in the nickel.
So we got Jones.
The blitz is on. Pressure coming. Spinning free.
When you never saw what happened there. I was too busy watching Calvin.
This guy has to be at the top of the list. He just never lets up out there.
Strike too deep. For me, this is a play I run on defense a lot. What, you mean we can get two defensive backs crashing?
The Bears come out in a dime packet. Pressure with the pass.
And that's what happens.
Good call by the defense as they sent the corner on a blitz.
He just had too much pressure in his face to see anything, and he threw one out there. Lucky for him.
Like, cornerback blitzes do way better for me than, like, even a good defensive lineman. Like a Julius Peppers doesn't do shit for me, but, like, blitzing, like...
From the 16-yard line.
But, like, blitzing my third string and fourth string cornerbacks do hit home way better. Even though I think Peppers would be just as fast as some of those guys.
Receives the handoff. They're going to spot this one at the 37-yard line. He got in there and made the tackle.
Yeah, it's going to be the 2 minute. All right. Try a toss. We don't do a lot of them. Let's try a toss. So I'm just what I've been doing lately is I've been sliding protection to the direction of where we're gonna run. I messed that up. If I had cut to the outside, that would have been a much bigger game. Go with our Hester option so we can get a curl to Booker.
You've got to make the stop.
Out of the I formation, dropping back to pass on first down with the pass. And he can't hang on to it.
He put the ball exactly where you want to put it.
We will be looking at receivers in the draft.
Troy goes with a four-man.
See, I want to go this way based on where that defensive tackle is. That was lucky.
Is there for the tackle at the 43-yard
line. All right, this would be perfect then to go PA rollout. He was sitting there waiting for me. We're going to block Olsen so he can secure the edge. And we're kind of looking at Hester here. There we go. He just had to eat that just a little bit.
I tell you, the defense has to do a better job of coming up and clamping down on the receiver whenever he enters their zone.
Okay, they are bunched over there, so let's run this way.
And off to the tailback, dropped in the backfield for a short loss. Nothing doing that time, John, as the linebacker gets there.
Fuck it, flea flicker time. What could go wrong? What could go wrong? What could possibly go wrong? Not Forte getting tackled before he could pitch it back.
On the defense. Gets rid of it. The defense.
I guess that could go wrong.
Yeah, he thought he had his man, but the defender was able to make that one move.
Oh, that's funny. I guess that could go wrong. I guess just an interception because it's thrown right to the defensive back.
Shifting some personnel up front. Kitna scans the defense from the gun. Dropping back to pass on first down. Throws it. Incomplete.
And if the guy's there, we should have taken him down. We're gonna stay in kind of this two-man under, so we can kind of like pseudo double cover Calvin Johnson. Oh God, what is this?
Chicago goes with a four-man front. Not today. Let us be clear. I can do it, baby. With the throw, incomplete pass. Number 98 comes
Dan
up to
Campbell
left.
Got messed up there.
The receiver's hands before he was able to get control of it.
Yeah, we see a lot of footballs popping.
Let's
up
go Sam shoot fire
contact.
Too.
His instincts know when to deliver the hit.
So we're going
to
fire. Oh, my God.
Chicago lines up
what
in
is
four
this?
Three.
What Williams, is going on
the man
on
in motion. The rush is on. Under pressure. Gets the pass off. Break. Takes him down before he can get the first. He gets the pass to his receiver, who will come up just short of the first down.
Never sure why a quarterback chooses that pass instead of one deeper downfield on that third down situation.
Harris comes into the game for the punt. Graham sets up, waiting for the punt.
Just fast forward, because I think they're going to kill clock, and I'm going to let them. Okay, another one there. Didn't work. All right, we got 1 second. Fuck it. Fake screen wheel.
And this should be the last play of the half.
This actually works pretty good as just a normal screen. Fine.
This one falls incomplete. It's the end of the second quarter with this.
And we get the ball. Oh, let's look at the game stats. 378 to 119. 125 rushing yards to 31. 253 to 88. A couple blemishes on the radar for Rex Grossman, but hey, we've got three tutties. And 9 of 26, John Kitna is throwing it at a 34% completion rate. And I think he has not been helped by drop passes. Only two drops is surprising. Us only having one drop is surprising. I think also, too, like, what the game constitutes. Oh, they get the ball. Okay. What the game con- oh, that's right, they got the fumble return. That's how they did it. But what the game constitutes as a drop is kind of not what
from the 7 yard line
looks like happens on the field. So
to the 22 yard line.
Let's see. Yeah, they're coming out and just base cover two. Come out nickel cover two. I actually flipped them correctly. Where the fuck is he going?
Chicago comes out in their nickel pack.
So he's gonna play the fucking defensive line here.
They give it to the halfback. Harris comes up to make the play at the 25.
The defense held their positions and didn't let him get very far.
Ball on their own 25.
I'm just going to play base cover, too. I don't really feel like we need to play anything too exotic. What in the fuck are you doing? Oh, my God. And drops an interception. Why does he keep why do they keep insisting on him going to the fucking defensive line? He's lining up in the fucking C gap.
The Bears.
Happy accident. Happy little accident.
The third down run comes up short, so we should see a punt here. Very solid defensive effort to force the three and out.
Jesus Christ. They
spot this one where it went out.
Not even a decent punt.
43? Ball on their own 43. Number 22. Gives the ball off. Lewis is there on the stop at the 49. Number 22 has been clearly a big part of their offensive plan. Now has over 125 yards rushing.
Ball on the 49-yard line.
All right, we're going to send Forte out so this works. Kind of looking at Marty Booker here, but we'll see.
Here comes the blitz. Deep throw. Knocked away.
We had blitz, so I just threw it over to Hester.
Even if he's caught out of position.
Okay.
That time he was right there in the secondary.
So we will run our curl route.
Was his intended target.
Because I like the route that Peterson runs here.
Peterson lines up behind his fullback in the eye. With the throw,
there you go.
Has it. Brian Kelly wraps him up and now has four tackles.
Hold take on a second. The penalty.
So the penalty on third down does go against the defense, and the result was a first down.
All
and that
right.
Penalty could be very costly as it moves the offense into scoring range. The Lions with a four-man front. Hand off to the tailback. Lewis is there for the tackle at the 18. Number 22 runs it through the middle again of about six.
Should I counter lead?
Inside the 20.
Ball on the 18-yard line.
Their last red zone trip resulted in a touchdown. They're humble. Loose ball. The Lions scoop it up.
It's that thing where, like, it doesn't give me the
come away with something when you get down inside the 20.
The fucking highlight stick
almost always get some kind of,
and I think it gives them the hit stick in exchange, because if we look at it, I think that's exactly what happened here. So I tried to... Let me if I can... So I tried to highlight... I tried to highlight stick this guy. So what happens is I go for the highlight stick. He gets me with the hit stick. So...
Changing things up along the defensive front. Jones, the lone setback, tosses it out to the right. Manning is there on the stop at the 39-yard line.
He's got everything you look for in a running back. Move, speed, power. I'll tell you, this guy is a complete package.
Ball on the 39-yard line.
Hold the look. Great shoot. Let us get
you. Shifting some personnel up front. Drops back. Pump faking. Deep throw. Touchdown. And this one isn't quite over. And it will be an interference call on that play. The only question was a defender or the receiver.
Why would they accept that?
Ooh, so they called on the offense, and that's big. Because they
why did they accept the penalty? What?
It's first and goal at the 2-yard line.
All right. Okay.
Here we are in the third quarter, and this is the first time they've been inside the 20-yard line. Urlach is there on the stop.
All right.
Blocking the knee, and now it'll be second down and goal. Just three
I guess. Don't know why they're trying tosses, but all right.
This team has to start converting on third down if they're going to be successful.
He loses it. The Bears scoop up the fumble.
Oh, my God. Okay.
And the thing is, he has to protect the ball when he's back there. He has to bring it down and cover it up with two hands.
Oh, okay.
Take a hit.
I cannot believe that just happened. They accepted the fucking penalty. Took away a touchdown off of their own scoreboard in exchange for first and goal at the 1-yard line. And what happens? We stuff them on first down, stuff them on second down when they tried to run it to the outside. And then third down, okay, shit, where it's third and five, or it's third and goal at the 5-yard line instead of the one. All right, well, shit, we got to throw it. They drop back to pass. We get a fucking strip sack? Are you serious? A strip sack? That's how that ends? And now here we are already in their territory because we got a good fucking... Oh, my God.
Gets rid of it. And it's complete. Spodden is there for this tackle.
I don't know how they get the good leaps like that. But I never get that. I get like the short hop. I don't know how they get the... jump where they are in the air for 15 seconds.
The offensive line looked like they just collapsed on that play.
The offensive line has to get good movement on the snap of the ball for the inside run to work, and it didn't happen on that play.
The Lions with a four-man front tucks it away. But is there for the tackle. Benson kept his legs moving, gets 7 hard-earned yards.
Okay, let's just do a toss.
For a score. Here are the numbers when it comes to third down conversions. Peterson lines up behind his fullback in the eye. Cross play to the left. This one will be spotted at the 9-yard line. The tackle is his 5th of the game. They can't
fine.
Get
I think if I,
down, but they're in field goal range.
If I took my finger off the sprint button and I just kind of cut it back a little bit or bent it back. Then I think we could have gotten the first down if we did it that way.
And give credit to the kicker there. It's nice to have a guy that can make your drive worth 3 even if you don't get it into the end zone every time.
This one is taken by Kaysom.
Kickoff return 11 yards.
Kaysom returns this one to the 20.
The ball Lions on their own will 20. Start the drive at the 20-yard line. First and 10.
So, yeah, I guess.
Kickoff from the shotgun. Dropping back to pass on first down. Tillman is there on the side.
I guess pass interference calls in the end zone aren't that bad.
Yeah, especially in situations where they're looking to get first down yardage.
Considering the fact that the AI will literally take a touchdown off of their own board.
This one falls incomplete. The defense was coming after him on that play.
He knew he didn't have much time, and he decided to get rid of the ball quickly on that one.
I really don't know why they accepted that. That's wild.
Only one man back. Dropping back. Pump faking. Looking for the deep pass down the right side.
Nice.
Just can't find a way to bring that one in.
Even though that pass was incomplete, that kind of pass stretches the defense, softening up the middle for passes underneath while allowing the running game.
Let's try this cover two. We won't do sync. We'll do this cover two. So we'll kind of protect the
I swear to God,
just fucking play your lanes.
Because they've been stopping him today.
Throws it. He hits his receiver. Urlacher comes up to make the play.
I think that was the same play that they got the touchdown on, because I noticed McDonald ran straight up the field. But I was actually able to cross over him or underneath him to get the inside track. Okay.
And this will be a touchback. Ball on their own 20.
Ball on the 20-yard line.
Here we go, baby. Keep moving.
Detroit goes with a four-man front. Goes with a halfback. Lewis is there on the stop. Good play by the linebacker to get into the backfield and stop the play for no gain.
I'll tell you, that comes from watching a lot of film and knowing the tendencies of the opponent. That was a heck of a play.
It's a blitz. Growing the 30.
Don't fucking do that. I don't know why I insist on trying to do a highlight stick.
Textbook first down.
Just because that's how all three of the fumbles have happened this game, where I've gone for the highlight stick, but it doesn't give it to me. And they get a hit stick, so the ball gets knocked loose.
And find a way to slow them down.
Ball on their own 41. They line up in the I formation, looking to run it here. White comes up to make the play at the 46. So he picks up about five.
Do challenges work differently, or do I not understand how challenges work? Because I assume that you have two challenges per half.
Side pursuit, which helped him get the first down.
First and 10.
Ball on the 46-yard line.
Hold the look.
They have the lead. One big reason is because they've done a real good job on the ground on first down.
Not bad, Vince. And that success leads to bigger and better things, usually.
Nothing dazzling there as they call the same running play twice in a row.
Keep doing that, man. I don't know.
Ball on the 45-yard line.
Ball on the 45-yard line.
This is actually like a great... All right, let's run it to the left.
Hand off to the tailback. They'll spot this one at the 42-yard line. He wraps up the ball carrier, and his tackle total is now 4. The Bears are handling the defense right now. They haven't even had a third down in this drive. Number 22 is the deep back. Handed off to the back. Breaking through. Smith comes up to make the play. They get 2 first downs on 2 running plays.
They're looking to pound it at him right now. First and 10.
I'm literally just in this, you know.
Detroit comes out in a 4-3. They give it to the halfback. Sim is there on the stop at the 21.
I'm just run to the left, run to the right, run to the left, run to the right, run to the left, run to the right. Just running wherever the line is going to block the best.
5-yard gain. And we'll
All right, we're going to take out Forte. He's going to get the rest of the night off. Excuse me. Sorry about that. Apologies, guys. Apologies.
The Lions come out in a nickel pack. Hand it off. Smith comes up to make the play at the 12. They're making him look easy out there. The fifth first down on this drive.
Yeah, and the key out there has been great play calling and even better execution.
Great play calling. I'm running the same two plays.
Benson, the deep back. Hand off to the tailback. He'll knock him out of bounds at the 1. They'll move the chains again after another long gain on the ground.
And we're having a lot of success running to the left, mostly because I think I can set up my blocks better.
And that's exactly what we're seeing.
Looking for the goal line. Touchdown, Bears.
That great subdued. That was a subdued celebration there for Cedric Benson there.
Comes in for the extra point. The extra point attempt is good. The Bears have it all working now as they continue to expand their lead.
I mean, I wish I could play, like, I wish I could have different defensive difficulty. Because I think I can play on all Madden offense. Okay. But I cannot play all Madden defense.
Looks like they're going to be able to come back in this one. But it's an issue of pride.
So maybe if the next game is a big blowout like this one has been, then maybe we'll try and adjust the sliders. I don't know which way we can adjust them or which way would be better to adjust them, to adjust the difficulty and then the sliders, or just adjust the sliders. Because I'm not sure which would be the better idea. Because I would like for these games to be a little bit closer. I mean, if I'm just playing by myself, sure, 45 to 10, cool. But on stream, I kind of want these games to be a bit more...
Pass play breaks down,
a bit more competitive, so they're a bit more interesting to watch. Because, yeah. Unless you're just enjoying the vibes, man. Like, I'm cool for vibes.
He can't bring it down in bounds.
The defense dug in their cleats and held their ground on that series of downs.
So as we get set for the punt, let's take a look at our returner's stats.
Or maybe I do the opposite, where I do all Madden defense and all pro offense. Where I can score at will, but so can they. Like that Atlanta game that we played last time. I think that was really good. We're just going to go back to lead dive.
Ball on their own 31.
Oh my God.
White is there for the tackle at the 35-yard line. Benson busted through for a few tough yards.
Do they have a play action here? Let's try it.
Ball on their own 35.
I mean, who cares? Except stats.
The Lions come out in a 4-3. They'll go with a play fake. Rosen, and he finds a wide open fullback. Bodden is there on the stop.
He got his 300 yards.
So the whole field was able to stand back there and find the open man.
You know, when a defense is sending extra rushes at the quarterback, it takes a lot of poise to get the ball out of there with any accuracy.
Benson is the deep back on the ground. Smith comes up to make the play at the 48-yard line. Benson runs it through the middle, a gain of about 6. Ball on the 48-yard line.
Ball on the 48-yard line.
So we're going to take it. It's showtime, baby. Nothing.
Detroit goes with a 4-man front. Hand it off. Kelly is there on the stop at the 39. And that game will get them a fresh set of downs.
It was a great run. He saw his blockers create some room for him.
I think,
and he accelerated right
I think right now what I'm thinking about is if we do... adjust the sliders. I think increasing the offense or increasing the computer offense would be the way to go. If that doesn't work, then maybe we do upgrade to all Madden and then degrade their defense and see if that works. Because I think if their defense or if their offense is better, then I think the games would be a little bit more competitive and enjoyable. Finally, kick the field goal. We got like a 10-mile-an-hour win. So, yeah, I think, but we'll see how the next game goes. If the next game is a lot like this, then, yeah, we definitely have to upgrade the difficulty. So.
This one is taken by Casey.
I mean, I'm just going to play zone.
One of those situations where they're playing for respect.
I'm going to play zone. See how things go.
But they have a lot of pride in their team. I'd expect to see them keep fighting until that final whistle.
The Bears come out with three down linemen and seven defensive backs. With the carry, Brown is there for the tackle at the 30.
That's fine. They can have that first down run. I don't really care. Nor would an actual defensive coordinator like.
Gives the ball off. Ogunwaye comes up to make the play at the 37-yard line.
I'm just going to keep giving you those runs if you want to take them.
He's one of those guys who is patient, accelerates quickly, and is very good at using his downfield blocker.
Throwing behind him, but he has it. Brian Urlacher is one of the more formidable tacklers in the league. Wraps up another one there. That's number seven for him.
Jeez, seven for Brian. He is making up for lost time.
He'll pass on the first down. Throws it. Knocked down.
Here's the thing. If you can't
coverage
get
was good there.
Then you get your hands up. And that's exactly what he did.
What's the hard count? Under 10, 10. Let's go.
Gets the pass off. He hits his receiver. Urlacher is there on the stop at the 49. Johnson makes a catch, but doesn't.
Same defense, same coverage. I'm just gonna keep running this cover two until they.
And they don't miss tackle.
The offense has had trouble moving the sticks on third down so far. Going long. Almost picked off.
Manning gets hands on it.
Yeah, he had great coverage, but the ball should have ended up in his hands, not on the turf.
Graham gets set for the return as we take a look at his numbers. He's gotten a workout today. He's now coming to punt eight times. This one goes out of bounds.
Not a very good punt.
First and 10. Ball on the 27-yard line.
The backs are lined up in an eye. He gets the count. Bullocks is there on the stop at the 36. He doesn't have blazing speed, but he'll just run you over if he has to.
He'll come out of the backfield and make a few catches, too, if you forget about him.
Detroit lines up in a 4-3. Tosses it out to the right. You could hear the collision.
Let's get the first down.
They did a pretty good job of recognizing what they wanted to. It just got there a little late.
Ball on their own 38.
Ball on the 38-yard line.
One more, fella.
Detroit using three linebackers. Gets the call. Dropped in the backfield for a short loss. Just back to the line of scrimmage, and that's it.
This defense could put the brakes on you real fast.
Yeah, they've put the brakes on us real fast.
38-yard line.
Hey, watch the screen.
Detroit comes out in a 4-3. Hand it off to the back. He's brought down behind the line for a short loss.
This defense has some good speed. When you try something to the outside,
try pass.
To get
full back.
Outside guys blocked.
Play action, fullback flat. We'll see what happens here.
Come out of the nickel pack. Setting up play action, and he finds a wide open fullback.
Almost.
Before he can get the first. He made the
almost got it.
Couldn't find a way to get past the marker. McDonald into return.
OK. Okay. Ooh, that's a good punt. Inside the 10. Just going to do cover two. Just going to do cover two. Let's just play back. We're just going to play back. They might run the ball. That's fine.
It's rid of it. This one falls incomplete.
All right, we knocked it free.
Yeah, I'm thinking they're going to keep going to the air, but it might be a little too late.
Play back. Don't want big play.
Come out with one linebacker and several defensive backs. Urlacher is there.
Shot block.
Tackle at the 14-yard line.
40 pass attempts. 40.
Going long. Caught out of bounds. Great effort up front to put the pressure on.
And you see that kind of thing out of these guys a lot. They're big and they're strong and they're fast. Opposing offensive lines sure have their hands full when they get out in this field.
Unable to get anything going on that series, they'll have to punt it away here. So the punt goes.
Why are these
out
the worst punts ever? All right, we'll kill clock here.
The backs are lined up in a nine. On the ground, White comes up to make the play.
They call timeout. We're going to fucking kick the ball. If we get into it, actually, I think we're in field goal range now, so. I think we're going to have to just quick get right back into it right away, so.
I can do it, baby. Check it out, baby. Check it. All right, let's go. Let's go. Keep moving. There we go, baby. Rock and roll.
Watch the man.
Danny. Go make the play.
Watch out.
All day, baby. Come on.
They give it to the halfback. Lewis is there for the tackle at the 32. Good pickup on the ground as they convert for the first.
Here's the thing. They were looking run and brought the blitz, but the back just used his vision and elusiveness to avoid him and get past the marker.
You gotta believe it, it's RJ. Watch the snap now. Let's do our thing. Let's do our thing.
He'll take him out.
Ball game. Da-na-na, na-na-na, ba-da-ba-da-ba-ba-ba.
Not much of a contest. One team pouring it on for a big margin of victory.
48, the Lions, 10.
This game is presented by the authority of the National Football League and EA Sports. Any publication, rebroadcast, or other use of the descriptions and accounts of this game without the express written permission of EA Sports is prohibited. This is Al Michael. Good night.
Let me actually do a little bit of a little bit of a slider adjustment. Just increase their offense a little bit is what we'll try to do. Yeah. I think it's gonna save. Just so it's not so much of an ass kicking. Yeah, if we didn't have that Eagle game, it definitely would be a lot different now. All right, so we're facing the 5-3 Titans. How are they defensively? Well, okay, I think defensively we'll see how it goes. Offensively is going to be the big thing. So let's, yeah, our pass defense is still absolute trash. So, and they have the best. So let me adjust my franchise gameplay settings. Is it custom game? AI, computer, just crank this up. Give their blocking really good. Immaculate catching. Just really, really good. And then let's give them amazing punting and field goal. So, and we'll just kind of leave defense as is. So hopefully they're a little bit better on defense, on offense, so it can be a little bit more competitive. All right. Games have been taking about an hour, and I have about an hour left. So let's check out the Titans first, and then we will get into the game. Let's see who is on the Titans. Vince Young, quarterback of the Tennessee Titans. Lendell White is the halfback. Amard Hall is the fullback. Algie Crumpler taking a trip into Tennessee. Brandon Jones and Justin Gage are the wide receivers. Michael Ruse, Leroy Harris, Kevin Mawe, Jake Scott, and David Stewart are your offensive line. Albert Hainsworth and Tony Brown is the defensive tackles. Javon Kearse and Kyle Vandenbosch. This is a good defense. This is a good defensive line. Holy crap. That rounds out the defensive line. David Thornton, Keith Bullock, and Ryan Fowler. Oh my gosh. That's a good linebacking core. Cortland Finnegan, Nick Harper, Michael Griffin, and Chris Hope are your defensive backfields. Rob Baronis and Craig Hendrick are your punters and kickers. Shit, they have a good defense, but their offense is not great. So we'll see how this goes. Hopefully those sliders actually affect things and Vince Young plays like he did in the national championship game against Southern Cal. We'll see. We'll see how things are moving and shaking and grooving. Sorry, I'm just checking the scores of the games that I'm keeping tabs on tonight. Nothing starts till 7, so we're okay. And I didn't check. Are we at home or are we in Tennessee? I don't remember. I do not remember. We are at home. All right. Back-to-back home games.
Chicago's beautiful lakefront area where today's game will take place.
Bum-ba-dum-bum-bum.
Both of today's teams are looking for a win and trying to...
All right. Sorry, Al Michaels. We got to get to the game. We want to tell us. I want the wind. I want the wind. You want the
both
ball. All right.
Eager to get today's action started, so let's go to the field.
All righty. We are currently leading the NFC North, thanks to several back-to-back-to-back wins.
He won't have a chance for a return here.
I think we've won three in a row since that Eagles game.
John, this one will really challenge the offensive
coordinators. Or four in a row.
As they go up against
might be a four in a row.
Defenses in the NFL.
Both of these teams
right.
Have
so let's just start two men under. I'm not sure where the panic is going to be here. I'm not sure who the... what the part of their offense is going to be really hard to stop, but we'll see.
Number 92 records the tackle. And 26, White picks up about 6 after that catch.
Like I said, we increased their sliders, so hopefully their offense is way better.
Making some changes along the defensive front. The Bears line up in a 4-3. Brown is there on the stop. 28.
Right now, they need to keep going at the defense with a run.
Okay, we'll go cover
sooner
two.
Sooner or later, they'll be able to break one for a big game.
Shifting some personnel up front.
Not going to do a stunt. We're just going to pinch and we're going to slide.
Gets the call. Urlacher, comes up to make the play.
No!
Ryan Urlacher is getting up very slowly. It looks like he'll head towards
I swear, if we lose him again, I'm going to be so freaking mad.
Wilson. We'll see more action now because of the injured linebacker.
Everything you've got. Left now.
Chicago lines up in a 4-3. Dropping back to pass on first down. Throws it.
Nice job, Tillman.
Tillman was there on the cover.
Go Bullets, man, zero.
The Bears come out in a 4-3. Receives the handoff.
Nice job, Hillenmeyer.
He's there on the stop at the 38-yard line. White takes advantage of a little daylight. Picks up.
I want... let's go man quarterback spy because I think Vince Young. Okay, he's got bursitis, so return.
He injured his knee, but it doesn't look too bad according to what we're being told, and we might see him get back into the game. With the pass.
Whoa!
Tillman comes up to make the play.
Whoa! Zoomed in to catch that ball.
Situations where they're looking to get first down yardage.
All right. Okay. We don't know what they're gonna do. Let's flip it. Okay, Eddie Kennison is on the right. Oh, okay.
Chicago comes out in their nickel.
Kind of played down a little bit. Kind of teeter into the box.
Gets rid of it. And it's complete. Break is there on the stop at the 45. Kennison didn't have much room to do anything.
Hey, I called him out. All right, Torpedo saw one. We're just going to send the linebackers. Can you disguise your... Okay, nope, they will not. All right, cool. I got Lendell White. Pick it up. Dvorak with another fumble recovery. Yowie. Wowie.
Tuck the ball away and not allow him to knock it out like that. Either has to take off with it, throw it away. But don't take a hit that's going to put
all right,
the ball
let's see how this is going
to
go.
You'll see him do that kind of thing a lot. As a quarterback, you want to make your pre-snap read. If you see him walking guys up to the line, you should audible to some kind of slant or quick out to take advantage.
Rosen.
Nice.
Harper comes up to make the play at the 33.
Yeah, now I have to, like, get out of my head of what we were doing at the end of the last game where we were just kind of like, I don't give a shit. Now I actually have to try again.
Your second and so on. He did a nice job of going through the progression that time.
Fowler is there on this.
Fowler's the weak part of their defense. So let's try play action slow, see if we can get, like, a... Erlacher's back. All right.
The Titans with a four-man front looking for room. Setting up play Shit. Action, pressure, throwing it
okay.
away.
I know how to throw it away.
Couldn't find a receiver, so he threw it where no one could get it.
Go back to our curls route.
Third down, and they have to get it to the
all I have to do is not get sacked.
Let's go. Peterson, the deep man. Gets rid of it.
Or throw an interception. Holy shit.
Was the intended
that was really close. Wow. And I should not have thrown an outside. I don't know why I targeted the outside. It's almost like self-sabotage. I threw it to Booker's outside shoulder instead of his inside shoulder.
So getting three was big. And they got to go over what worked and what didn't. So the next drive, we'll get him a TD.
Good distance. The kick sails out of the end zone. Tennessee trying to push this one all the way down the field for the lead.
Let's see what we can do. Let's start in cover three. I'm not sure what they're, how they're going to attack us.
The defense is shifting.
So I don't know what I need to prepare for. I don't know if I need to, like, prevent deep passes, or they seem to be running it a lot, but I don't know if, like, I should be preventing against the run. Should I protect the pass? Should I protect the run? Like, what's the
Bears line up in a 4-3. gives the ball off. Urlach is there for the
tackle. And me, I was in on the stop. Go Sam, shoot, fire two. So we're going to send Hillenmeyer. So we're bringing five, and then we got to cover two. We're going to leave the fullback unblocked. It's like a double counter. Play calling's weird. It's not normal that the AI runs it on third down. And maybe that's the thing. Maybe that's the problem, is like AI decisions are still going to be kind of stupid. Even on all pro, so.
From the 40.
I don't know. But I think I would rather have like dumb decisions, but it still works in our favor, versus like they make a dumb decision, but it still works out for them because fuck you, that's why.
Formation. To carry it. Hurst comes up to make the play.
So
47-yard line.
A tough running game.
Straight Olsen option. You kind of have both the Forte option here or the Hester option. With the linebacker going out, it makes me feel like it's zone. I have no idea what's going on there.
They're coming with the blitz. Going long.
Shit.
This pass is incomplete.
Wasn't able to throw it the right way I wanted to.
Every quarterback needs a little time to look over the field. There we saw a defense who wasn't given any time at all.
It's a lot of tack.
Third and six.
Kind of see what they do here.
Grossman changed the defense from the gun. Throwing. And he
nice.
Hits his target. Harper is all there right for the tackle. All the at the 42, Grossman is right on the mark with that throw.
Third down is when you really need your quarterback to be sharp, because the temptation to force something in is bigger. That time he found the right guy and he made a good throw.
Curse comes up to make the play.
As a coach, you need to make sure that you establish your running game as a weapon that can hurt the other team.
God, I don't like any of the play action plays on this formation, and I want to kind of like double up. So let's try this. I think Hester or Olsen are going to be the plays here. Oh, I thought Fowler was going to get hands on it. I fully expected him to get hands on it.
Could have been shot out of a gun with the velocity it had on it.
Hand off to the tailback. Bullock is there on the stop at the 22-yard line.
It's important to pound the defense with a run. Sooner or later, they're going to bend.
Okay. Olsen option. I like Hester making this corner route, especially with potentially man defense.
Going long to the left.
Bonk.
He's got it. Touchdown, Bears. Rex Grossman.
That's their dope.
Weakness in the defense and makes them pay.
I'm just glad the rush didn't get me and they gave me enough time to throw it.
Number nine comes in for the extra point.
And we threw a nice accurate ball, so that's also good.
They did everything they had to on
that. All right. Up 10-0 on this defense.
Goal line and a TD on the board.
Definitely think that passing is going to be the way to go. So I'm going to have to be smart about how I do it.
This one is taken by Carr.
Because running the ball, I just
on the offense's last possession.
I just think we're going to have to really, really just kind of exploit their tendencies.
Young gains the defense from the gun. Looking for the long completion down the left side. It's batted away.
Get out of here. You're in my zone. You're in my zone, and you would have fucking had a touchdown if I tried to intercept that, so.
Gage was his intended target.
Let's go cover one plug. I'm okay with giving me an assignment. Okay, so we're going to shade towards Crumpler. Oh, look at that, getting in the passing lanes.
He has his eyes in the backfield the whole time, and he was right there to break the play up.
Look at that, getting in the passing lanes.
Shifting some personnel up front. Throwing. comes up to make the play at the 26-yard line.
Nice job. Playing good defense here. Playing smart defense.
Pattern that was short of the first. Makes no sense to me.
Unable to get anything going on that series, they'll have to punt it away here. And he chooses not to return this one.
Fair catch made at the 29-yard line. First and 10. Ball on the 29-yard line.
Play hard and fast, baby.
The Titans come out in the 4-3. Tucks it away. Curse is there for the
Jesus, Javon Curse with another one?
This is one of those games where you just keep running it at him. 4 yards here, 5 yards there, loosen him up, and then when? You knock him out late in the game with that long touchdown run.
Let's try a play action fullback flat. I don't know if play action deep ball is going to work here, but hopefully we can at least get time to.
Nope.
Bad throw.
Trying to throw a deep one, but incomplete, and then I'll face third down.
I'm going to
go Hester option here.
The Titans line up at a 4-3. Throws it. He finds his man.
Nice job.
On the stop at the 39-yard line.
I'm also trying to run like different plays and formations than what I normally do, just so I can kind of like, I don't know.
Looking for room. Fowler is there for the tackle.
This is a spot where you want to show the defense that they have.
All right, let's try a roll out here.
Picked up about 6 yards.
We're gonna have Olsen in the block. I'm gonna basically go.
With a four-man front, play action. It's rid of it.
Gosh, too much.
He can't bring it down inbounds.
Too much.
Not what he was looking for. Receiver on the play.
Let's go whip unders.
And here's a look at each.
Should be a decent play for.
Down so far. The Titans come out in a 4-3. Stepping up, throwing. It's broken up.
It's a good play.
The kind of play they've come to expect from him. He always seems to make a big play just when they need him to.
Olsen was the one they were trying to get the ball to. Maynard comes into the game for the punt. Carr sets up, waiting for the punt. This one goes out.
Not a good punt. Robber one pistol, so we're going to do cover one, and Urlacher's going to do a delay, blitz.
The Bears line up in a 4-3, throws it, he finds his man.
Stick to him like glue, boys.
At the 36-yard line, Young completes the pass, good pickup, about 7 yards.
Let's go Sam Fire, we're going to contain on the right-hand side. That's the quarter.
Jumped out to an early lead as the first quarter comes.
Good start for us.
Starts the second quarter.
Second and three. Ball on the third.
We're gonna bring five.
The Bears come out in a dime packet. Looking for room. Setting up play action. Throwing. He hits his receiver. The 50. Brown comes up to make
just
the
making
play.
Sure we make the stop.
Nice ball going to the air, and that'll move change.
All right, we'll go back to our slant Sam one fire.
Under pressure, it's rid of it.
Oh my goodness.
And he goes out of bounds. At the 29. They throw it.
I'll risk the timeout.
I'm
not sure he got that.
It'll be reviewed.
The call in the field is questionable. They might decide that they made an incorrect call and reverse it.
And as the official takes a look at the play, so will we.
And the issue here.
No,
is
he did not.
The official called him out of bounds.
Look,
now
right foot in, left foot.
Both feet in bounds, but did he have possession?
Out.
After reviewing the play, the ruling on the field stands. Completed pass, the player had control of the ball.
What?
The coach thought it could have been reversed, but it didn't turn out.
Bullshit! Bullshit! This is horseshit! All right. Here we go. Catch. 1 foot. Has touched. Second foot has not touched. And it steps out there. Oh my gosh. That's some BS, man. 1 foot does not equal, 1 foot twice does not equal 2 feet. All right, we got the stop. 1 foot does not equal 2 feet. 1 foot twice does not equal 2 feet.
Chicago lines up in a 4-3. Play action with the throw, almost picked off.
That was right to you, bro. I think we might be able to get away with just running coverage. They're really liking doing play action. Okay, they're in zone, or they're in shotgun.
Closing in, going for six. The defense has it.
Let's go, Peanut. Let's go, Charles Tillman. My boy. Try whip unders again. Let me try and read this play better.
After the interception, they'll set up shot at the 26. Number 22, the lone back. The blitz is on. Pressure coming.
All right, we're going to run the ball.
Javon Curse, when he's healthy, is one of the best pass rushers in football.
Oh, no.
He has a great first step. He has a pretty good second step and third step, too. And if you don't get ready to block him, if you don't get up quickly as a pass protector, he's going to be right by you.
On the ground, Fowler is there for the tackle.
Didn't get the blocks there.
20-yard line. Number 22 takes advantage of a little daylight and picks up 3 yards.
What are we going to do here? They're probably going to be in, like, I don't know. Let's try a slot cross.
Third and 15. Ball on the 20-yard line. Let's go
now. Number 25, the lone back. They give it to the halfback. Play action. With the throw, and he makes, no, he can't hold it in.
All he can do is look at his hands and wonder what the heck happened.
Yeah, what did happen there, Earl Bennett? My God, dude. I was able to throw him open, but.
He signals for a fair catch.
Yeah, I was able to throw him open, but like, couldn't really get anything going there. All right, let's try DB Cannon there.
So they have first and 10 here. All
right, this will work.
The Bears come out in a dime package. They're coming with the blitz.
God, it's like he reads it immediately. It's almost like I massively increased the quarterback ability.
Some quarterbacks love blitzing corner because they know that there's one less cover man out there and they have a lot better shot at hitting someone in stride.
Incomplete.
They're hitting those quick, they're trying to go with quick passes, so I wonder if doing a coverage might be better. So we can kind of like get in the throwing lanes.
Slight change in the defensive alignment, making some changes along the defensive front. With a counter play. Brown is there.
All right.
On the stop.
I got him out. Out of one line.
He was looking for a place to run, but all those places were
filled
up with guys. All
right, let me try and. No, we don't have a sync coverage, so we'll go three deep, I guess.
Third down play here. They have to get it to the 36.
I'll cover two. All right, that'll, that should be better.
Chicago comes out in their nickel package. Throws it right on target to the wide receiver. Urlacher takes
Let's
him
do
down
it.
Before he can get the first. Jones stopped just short of the first down marker on that catch.
That's weird that they're, yeah, this is, and they have the win.
Is ready to pump this one away. Graham will go back to accept.
Yeah, that's weird. Why would they? Okay. Past the goal line. Whatever. No, we'll take it. Here. Yeah, I don't know why they wouldn't just kick it, kick the field goal there, or attempt the field goal there. But.
The Titans line up in a 4-3. Hand off to the tailback. Ainsworth is there on the stop.
Jesus.
25-yard line.
This team's always trying to get a good mix of run and pass plays.
Ball on their own 25.
Ball on the 25-yard line.
It's showtime, baby.
They line up in the I formation. Throwing. Fowler makes the tackle.
Didn't get my
and
fucking
29-yard line. Grossman completes the short one.
Hit stick.
Second down. Ball on their own 29.
See if this play will work.
They'll go from the I formation.
Because I think they're going to try and crash. I think they're going to try and crash for a run.
Going for the first on short yardage. He was hit just as he threw. It's broken.
I'll tell you, the defense made a great stand right there.
Run!
Fucking Javon Curse. Forte is wide ass open, and I was just trying to get it to him. God damn it. Fucking Javon Curse. Son of a bitch. It's exactly what I was expecting to happen, except I was hoping that I could get enough time to throw.
Carr is back to receive this kick. He's waving.
But the best defensive line move in this game is just run around the tackle. Fuck, dude. Oh, if I kept Olsen on the
ball on their own 33.
I kept, oh, but I liked. Oh, damn it. I got to figure out what I do with that.
Young sends a man in
where it's like third and short. I got to figure out, like,
it's the call.
I got to figure out, like, what the best way to go about that is, because
and break loose into the secondary.
I think we can exploit that for a big touchdown. I'm going to go bullets. This is probably a mistake. But I'm going to just try and protect the run. Thank you, Daniel Manning. Thank you.
With all that pressure, there wasn't much he could do with it.
Yeah, and all he did was throw it right at the defender. Either has to throw it away or take off.
Yeah, I think if we, like, kept Olsen
in
on this play. Oh, he's
pass play here on first down. Looking long down the right side of the
come
field.
On.
It's caught. Hulk comes up to make the play at the 1 yard line. Ears it out and picks up a big first down.
Yeah, it looked like the quarterback and receiver had that one together. The defense lined up in man and the offense went.
I just kind of wanted to make sure that the fuck, how am I gonna get this? This big, yeah, that's what we were running at the end of last game. I wanted to see if Forte would be able to beat the
number 22 in the backfield looking for the goal line.
There we go.
Touchdown Chicago.
Multiplayer.
I'll tell you, they just knocked that defensive line backwards on that play. Watch it here. The offensive line explodes off the ball. The defense can't.
I don't know why they're highlighting his receiving, but okay.
And the runner is in the end zone.
He should have had a touchdown that third down play, but we kind of made up for it, I suppose.
The extra point attempt is good. So following that touchdown, the score is 17-0 there. Number 9 is back and
make them pay after
a in the air.
Interception.
This one is taken by Carr.
Kickoff return, 14 yards.
Still not quite sure what to do against them. Like, I think the zone is working, but I don't know for sure. I always forget to fucking flip the goddamn play.
Shifting some personnel up front. The Bears come out in a nickel package.
Hmm.
Going for the deep man.
Okay.
So they don't get the completion, and the defense got a little lucky there.
Go 3-2-6. And we'll just go cover two again.
Second and 10. Ball on the 22-yard line.
Need a hammer, not the nail. Tim,
making some changes along the defensive front. White, the lone setback.
Let me bring it tight.
Drops back. Okay. Pressure launches it deep to the left.
Oh, look at that user! Yahoo! Zaher! Delpha.
Woo!
No fly, baby.
Strap. You put it up, and boom, you get the interception.
And I returned it. Oh, no, we got to get like 15 yards for us to be in field goal range.
At the 34-yard line, only one man back. They give it to the halfback. Harper is there on the stop.
They're so quick with getting that.
That's just the kind of thing that the defensive coordinator.
Yeah, they're like so quick with reading that. All right, so we're going to read Olsen here.
They'll bring the blitz.
Just get that out. If he's got the body block, he'll be okay.
Good job of getting rid of it in time.
Let's try whip unders again.
Third down, and I'll have to try.
I think the last time we ran this play, Greg Olsen, or not, fucking Javon Curse broke away with the sack.
Gets rid of it. And he drops the pass.
Pretty good play call on that. Everything happens just as it's drawn up. Just couldn't hang on to it.
It's one of those where I could have ran for it and probably gotten it. But I was like, oh, hey, Olsen's going to be running open here in a second.
The key to winning is having your drive.
Another drop pass
sort of
on third down. Not really much we can do about that. Except,
sure,
I don't know, get better players who don't drop the ball, but.
Booming kick downfield. This one is
my user pick goes for nothing. It goes for nothing.
The Titans have their work cut out for them as they take over.
We'll stay in cover too. I don't. It's hard to tell if coverage is working against this offense or not.
From the gun.
But.
Pass play here on first down.
Oh, all right.
He's gonna run it.
I wanted a hit stick. I wanted a hit stick.
29-yard line.
All right, so if we're going to come out in coverage like that, we need to have some sort of containment. Where is... We just got to make sure Urlacher... Oh, hey, we can... Let's go cover one linebacker spy. I would rather have cover two with a spy than cover one, but we'll take what we can get, I guess. Because that's kind of what I want to prevent against.
You know what this does? It keeps one defense on the field. And it doesn't let them get the right personnel in there sometimes.
Dropping back to pass on first down. With the pass, Mike Brown
tried to rip it from
him. For his third tackle.
What they're doing here is keeping the defense from huddling up. And it keeps the same defense on the field.
And he fucking runs now.
Break comes up to make the play at the 28-yard line.
Here's a no huddle. It's a
fine, we'll
do
cover two. Oh, wait.
Down.
What? That's just an audible? Oh, fuck yeah. Let's go.
Is a good defensive end. He's tough against the run.
I didn't know that was just
a very good pass rusher.
Fuck.
Gets rid of it. He hits his receiver. Touchdown, Titans.
I was trying to make coverage adjustments, and I hit square
touchdown
as he hiked it.
By
fuck.
Beating the coverage.
Cover two does have some holes, especially.
Let's watch that one more time. This is how they scored. So I'm trying to make a coverage adjustment, and I just. It's literally the second he hikes the ball. And what do? Run a corner out. Touchdown. Easy touchdown. I'm trying to make adjustments. Fuck!
Number two comes in to attempt the point after. The point after is good. Young completed pass after pass, having for all the yardage on that drive.
Yeah, he and his receivers were on the same page, and that got him a score.
And he got all of that one, a great day. He won't have a chance for a return here.
It's annoying.
Just about ready for the first play of this drive. They were able to pick up a field goal on their last drive.
Forte option. Let's see what we can get here.
The Titans come out of the nickel package. He'll pass on first down. He hits his receiver, the 30, and he steps out of bounds at the 39. That was a good adjustment by the receiver as he reads the man's coverage and finds open space.
Halfback flat.
Everyone has to make their read quickly and make
their coverage quicker. All right, we're throwing for 50% completion percentage right now.
Takes a lot of repetition and practice.
With the pass, and he hits his target. Hulk comes up to make the play at the 49, and it's good.
Bears cross. You can't see it, but I'll show it to you here in a second.
The Titans come out of a nickel packet.
Ah!
It was tipped.
Play cover two.
I tell you, that's exactly what you're supposed to do if you don't reach a quarterback. Get your hands up and cause an incomplete.
Slot outs.
Second and 10. Ball on the 49-yard
line. Shoot.
Here we go. The Titans come out in a dime package. Fires this one deep. Ooh, nearly picked off.
Maybe too much air under that.
So the offense still has possession.
And that's the last thing you want as a defender, to have the ball go right through your hands.
We can get conversion here.
Grossman will work out of the shotgun. Gets rid of it, and the catch is made. Booker makes the catch, but he's just short of the first down.
Direct snap. Kill time. See if we can.
We'll try to pin them inside the 10.
Yeah, we'll go under 30.
Oh, that's right. The defense sleeping on that one. Excellent decision going with a fake punt.
This coach loves to take chances and keep the defense off balance. Perfect example right there.
I like Bradley here.
Nickelback in this time. With the pass.
Fuck off.
He's got great recovery.
That's bullshit.
Even if he's caught out of position.
Vikings, thanks for the follow.
In the secondary to tip the ball away.
Bradley was the one they were trying to get the ball.
That
to.
Is some bullshit.
Ball on the 37-yard line.
Hate when the linebackers make fucking plays
out
like
of the
that.
Shotgun. Throws it. And this pass is completed. Number 31 makes the play at the 25. They get first down yardage on that hookup.
Wide receiver corner.
So after that nice catch and run, here's a look at his stats.
I don't know why I'm running this play. This is a mistake.
With the pass, incomplete.
Okay.
Number 23 was the intended receiver on that play.
Let's go with the field goal. Let's just take the points we have.
So they're lining up for the kick. This will be a 42-yard attempt.
Jesus. Held up there for an extra second or so. I feel so stressed even though I'm up 23-7. As long as they don't get a kick return for a touchdown here. Fucking knock on every piece of wood you have. Alright.
Going into halftime, the score is 23-7.
And we get the ball, I believe. How are we doing? How's our drops, more importantly? 12 of 25. Much different than last game. And we're averaging 2 yards a carry. This is great. 3 drops. I don't remember Hester's drop, but I remember Bennett and Olsen's drops. So, hate to see that, right? Hate to see that.
Number two, looks like he's
we won't get a kick return here because they got the wind at their back. No has to return so far.
This one is fielded.
Oh, I didn't know he was going to catch that. I got scared.
Ball on their own 20.
This Titans defensive line is scary. Their linebackers are good. Their corners are solid. So yeah, we're not getting anything running the ball. So everything we get is through the air. Let's see. We're going to probably do Booker. I think Olsen would be a good call here. We'll take McKee. Just take the yards. It's like it's here. It's open. Let's go ahead and grab it. God, I don't like anything here. Let's go Earl option. We can go to Hester deep. We can go to Bennett. With a four-man front. With the pass, almost intercepted. I was hoping he would sit.
He's a pretty good cover.
I was hoping he would sit.
Most guys, and he gets good position. Then he reads the pass, and he makes his move. He'll drop a few like that one.
It sucks that I have to, like, read them, and I can't just expect them to do something.
This a game, they have to buckle down, right, avoid mistakes, and work hard to dig themselves out of this hole.
Let's go cover three. I think coverage is working. Okay, so they're doing that.
The Bears line up in a 4-3.
And then we're gonna line shift.
Looking for room. Okay. Gunlaye comes up to make the play. At the 46.
The best backs in the league average 4 to 5.
I guess we're
gonna
have to be okay with giving them that.
Have good play calling, good blocking up front.
Good DN contain. Yeah, I know we're not playing
they're making some changes up
coverage, or we're playing man here instead of zone, which tends to not work out well for us, at least in this game.
He's brought down behind the line for a short loss.
He's had a tough day out there so far.
It doesn't matter. We're going to come out and immediately call cover two spy. So.
Let's go. Chicago with six defensive backs.
That's why we do that. That's where we do that. Yes.
So they'll line up the punt after going 3-0.
Oh, did he cough in it?
Into the end zone, touchback.
That was really close. Let me try a counterplay. I'm actually not convinced that this... I'm not even convinced that this is going to work. Because with the way their corners have been jumping these outside runs, I feel like even if we do get this sell...
Griffin is there on the stop at the 28.
You can't have a good running attack without blocking. But blocking alone won't get you what you need. You got to have a back who can find the holes when they're there.
Let's try a boot. Famous last words. We'll try a boot. Oh, God, what is this?
A lot of speed on the field for the defense as they line up in the fourth. It's rid of it.
Nice.
His pass is completed. Fuller comes up to make the play.
I was going to try and run for it, but... oh, whoops.
They're going to go with a no huddle. The blitz is on. Under pressure. Flips the tackle. Curse is there for the tackle at the 44. It's going to be second and just a couple after a good run.
Now, what the defense has to do is get a push in the middle and get a rush to the outside and keep him contained. He got loose on that one.
God, why is my fucking...
eight guys in the box.
What purchase?
Let's go, boys! Yeah, you see me.
Gives the ball off. Harper is there on the stop at the 33. And he was able to create a lot of space on that run, John.
Well, it started with some good blocking. And when he got through there, he turned upfield and they weren't in position to tackle him.
Oh, okay. All right, sorry. There's a very large Amazon order that was purchased under my account, and I was like, what the heck?
Ball on the 33-yard line.
Ball on the 33-yard line.
Here we go, baby.
The Titans come out in a 4-3.
Ah!
Keith Bullitt has it.
That's why I screamed.
Grossman throws that one right to the defense,
Buck.
John.
Yeah, he thought he had his man, but the defender was able to make that one move to get position, and it was over.
So they're ready to go on offense after the interception. They'll start at the 24. Nickelback in this time. Gets the pass off. Nearly intercepted. Tennyson was his intended target. Jonas with the coverage.
I like doing cover two. So it's cover two spy is R1. And then we'll flip it. Okay, that didn't matter.
Hand it off. Stillman comes up to make the play at the 31.
You got to keep going to the run. You never know when there's going to be a great.
Oh, we have cover two spot in our play call. Flip it. I always forget to flip it.
Only one man back. Hand it off to the back. Great fake with the throw.
Oh, I'm a liability.
The 30, the 20,
I wasn't.
Touchdown.
I wasn't strafing. I also didn't know who was getting the ball. If it was the tight end or if it was the... Fuck.
Jesus Christ.
No matter what kind of field position you start with, as an offensive player, you got to be thinking touchdown. These guys
it's a 9-point game.
Exactly,
we got to try and get a field goal or better.
This one is handled by number 23. The defense intercepted a pass their last time out.
Yeah, they did.
Ball on their own 20. The Titans with a four-man front. Looking for room.
Oh my God.
They're going to spot this one.
What did Haynesworth? Jesus Christ. What is that? Holy shit. I don't know what to say about that. Holy cow.
Tucks it away. Throws it. He hits his receiver. This one will be spotted at the 42-yard line.
Get that one.
Right there once again and recorded his eighth tackle. First and 10.
Ball on the 42-yard line.
All right.
The Titans come out of a nickel pack. Gets the pass off, and he can't hang on.
He put the ball exactly where you want to put it.
Earl! My name is Earl. I can't catch a fucking football.
Only one man in the backfield.
What? 53? It's Greg, 28. Let's go.
Blitz is coming. Going long. What a catch. Number 31 is...
All right, at least we got Hester there. Jesus Christ.
They have a lot of respect for his speech. A lot of times he gets a pretty big cushion. And that's where he's going to want to break off a route and use his speed to create run after the catch.
Okay. We might have man here.
And they're threatening again with the ball inside the 20. Pass play here on first down. Throws it. And this pass is complete. Running with purpose. Griffin
was nervous.
On the stop at the 3-yard line. So they get two first downs on their last two plays.
And they're getting it done by seeing the whole field and taking what the defense gives them.
It's first and goal at the 3.
We are going to try to just push this in.
Number 22, the deep man. He gets the catch. Harper comes up to make the play at the 1-yard line. Number 22 paddles his way forward for what appears to be a 2-yard pickup. They're just a yard away now.
All right, if we don't get it here, I think I'm going to try the quarterback sneak. Jesus Christ, look at what we got at the handoff here.
When it comes to third down conversions, trying to sneak it, touchdown.
That's not multiplayer. That was subdued.
Touchdown, Bears.
I'm gonna pause recording. All right. Welcome back, recording. I just took the picture for the thumbnail, so you already know what it looks like. You're over there. Sorry, I was pointing at my newly created bat wing that I'll show you here in a minute.
Number 9 comes in for the extra point. Cut. The extra point attempt is good.
My lovely girlfriend got me this weekend, and I spent three and a half hours putting it together. Fucking bat wing. It's a bat wing. It's so cool.
They do a great job of executing them when they run them.
I have no idea where to put it because where my other Batman stuff is on the top shelf. I think it's just out of view, but it's on the top shelf there. And I have like a little Batmobile and like the Joker with a safe. So I have no idea where I'm going to put this Batman or with this, the Batwing. I have no idea.
Been a rough start.
I have a lot of space over there, so
have enough time to turn it around.
Yeah, I don't know how to display that, but we'll figure it. We'll figure something out. We'll continue this cover two and spy deal. I think playing coverage. You know, we're gonna live with my user picks and die with my terrible route. Oh my god. Oh my god.
First through the line and almost took it for a touchdown.
And here's the thing. He was in and out of the hole so quickly. He was just
yeah, I think we're going to live and die based on my play at safety here, apparently.
Danny.
The Bears with a four-man front. Gets the pass off. Incomplete.
Just straight up drop there.
I'll tell you, there are plenty of guys in the league who take pride in making.
All right, what do we have for some kind of... I don't love that quarterback contain... I guess we'll play cover two spy again.
The defense is shifting. Chicago comes out in their nickel back.
Oh god, it's a run.
This one is spotted at the 37-yard line.
They're doing so much like mixing of play action and
first down. That's the second time on this drive.
You know what? Let's just bring the linebackers.
Chicago comes out in their nickel pack.
I have Lendell White.
Looking to run it here. Urlach is there.
There we go.
Came with a blitz and there wasn't anywhere to go.
Yeah, and that's why you send all those guys.
Sam shoot fire two.
At that time, there were no holes.
Urlacher has 8 more tackles. Let's go.
Changing things up along the defensive front. Chicago goes with a 4-man front. A little misdirection. Ogunwaye comes up to make.
Bring more pressure. They're getting too cute with it.
They went backward on that loss.
And that's a very good call by the defensive coordinator. He had a good idea of what was coming, and he called the perfect play to stop.
It's overload blitz here. So, let's overload it to the other side. Okay. We'll see what they end up calling. Okay. I'm going to continue with overload blitz. They're giving me a chance to switch out of it, but I'm going to say no, and now it's the other side.
Young starts out of the shotgun. Here they come. Gets the pass off. Urlacher is there for the tackle.
Perfect.
35. Crumpler doesn't get enough to convert, and that brings up fourth down.
Cannon flat four. We're going to bring pressure. I'm going to bring him off the other edge.
Shifting some personnel up front. I don't think they have a choice. They have to go for it. Looks to the end zone. And he can't hang on. They failed to get the first. And turn
I want
to
see what happened
down.
There. I close my eyes because I'm like,
game,
what's happening?
Play. Sometimes high.
Oh, he tries for the one hand. No shit.
Try a different play next time.
No shit. He tries for the one hand, dude.
To make the play at the 37. Number 22 paddles his way forward for what appears.
Let's try this boot to the left. I really don't know what to do if we don't get a seal.
The Titans come out in a 4-3. Play action with the throw, knocked away. Also was the one they were trying to get.
Yeah, I don't. I should never run that play ever again. Let's try Olsen option here.
Third and eight.
Not sure. Oh, great. They're coming out in this.
The Titans come out in the quarter defense. Here they come. Closing in. Going long. He's got Harper.
Let's go.
At the 32. He makes another.
Heat kicked on in the house, so now.
Yards and receptions today.
My boy.
So they have first and 10 here.
I hate when they come out in that defense because I just have no idea what they're going to be doing, and then it's just people everywhere. It's just people everywhere, and I'm like, what do I do with this?
Pushing his way through the would-be tacklers, he picks up solid yardage. Ball on the 22-yard line. Out of the I formation. Going to the air on first down. Gets rid of it. Drops the interception.
What the defense is doing is they're watching the quarterback's eyes. They're cluing. They're in position so that whatever happens, the ball is in front of them. And that time, it almost got him an interception.
Keep moving. Stay at home.
The Titans line up in a 4-3. Nice play fake. Throws it. Gets his hand on it.
Come on!
He needs to do a better job putting the pass in the spot where only his guy can get it. Those tip passes can turn into interceptions pretty easily.
Olsen was the intended receiver on that play.
Tired of that. I'm so tired of that. Them, the linebacker just jumping 6 feet in the air.
Only one man back. Gets rid of it. Behind him. Is there on the stop at the 17, short of the first down.
I just want to complete the pass.
Number 9 is heading onto the field for this field goal attempt.
God, we should have had a touchdown on that fucking play, but of course the linebacker is up his ass. Through the upright.
Return here.
They need one quick score and then some more.
Let's do zone pistol 3. If you know me, you know I like this play. All right, I don't know where the strong side is. Probably the right.
Comes out in a 4-3. Skate comes in motion. No misdirection. Is there for the tackle.
All right, Tommy, good job.
Play calling is very surprising considering the size of the deficit.
This is not a good time to sneak in a running play. They need lots of yards real fast.
Second and 4. Ball on the 26-yard line.
Rabbit. Play football.
Young scans the defense from the gun. Throws it. Broken up.
Good deal.
Was his intended target.
That's why I kind of like playing cover 2. There we go. Let's cover 2 sink.
So as they get set to try to convert,
we're going to bring a blitz to kind of force Vince to throw it.
Out of the shotgun.
Let's go. Let's go now.
Danny.
No, it's a quarterback run. God damn it.
He won't risk trying for more.
As soon as the line just opened up at the center, he was just gone. He's like, I'm going
that
way.
Changes along the defensive front. Gives the ball off. Brown comes up to make the play. And they're going to try to run the ball to pick up more first downs. Second and seven.
Ball on the 35-yard line.
Get it up, so we're going to take it.
Stop. I fucking hate that.
Line up.
Such a pet fucking.
Receiver set this time.
Harris such a fucking
there
pet.
For the tackle at the 36-yard line. Didn't get very far.
This is a guy who's willing to run with it any time on any down in any situation. This time the defense was ready, and they got him before he could get very far.
They'll go with the quarter defense. Gets the pass off. Pass ball's incomplete. Tennessee fails once again to get the first down of that seven times.
Yeah, and that's huge for the defense to keep stepping up on third down like that. They're a solid
cover two spy. Cover two spy. We are going to protect against fucking Vince Young running.
Well, if the defense can stop him one more time, they'll get it back.
Oh, I guess I didn't need a flip play.
Gets rid of it. It's going the other way. Manning is the lucky recipient of that tipped pass.
There's some luck involved, but also skill, because the ball starts going.
All right,
all
here we go.
Directions, and you got to be able to catch it, knowing that other guys are going for it too.
He hands it off. Keith Bullitt wraps him up, and now has four tackles. Number 22, running hard, going right through the arm tackles.
72. Ball on the 34-yard line.
We got to try and kill some time with this drive, because. We can kick the field goal and go up 36-14. Yeah. I think a combination of good defense plus our adjustments is actually kind of why this game feels a lot more competitive, which is a little bit more of what I want. Yes.
Is there on the stop.
First down.
He just barely finds his way past the marker. Ball on the 31 yard line.
We can take this under.
They line up in the I formation.
You can take it under. All right, you need to get past the
yard line. Number 22 takes it up the middle for a yard or two. Second and nine.
Ball on the 30-yard line.
The Titans come out in a 4-3.
I'm fast forwarding so this doesn't take as long.
For the tackle at the 27-yard line.
3-yard gain on the play.
I really want to try fullback flat.
Ball on the 27-yard line.
I just want to try it. I just want to try it, all right?
And we've reached the 2-minute mark.
We're going to keep Olsen in. If they commit to the run here,
play fake. Takes off. Breaking through. Thornton is there on the stop at the 20.
All right, we'll continue to I'm wearing shorts that like sometimes my, you know, my giblets show. If I'm not being careful. So, and since I'm like backed up, I want to be careful.
On the carry. Ball comes up to make the play at the 19. He They continue to pound it on the ground as this game nears its finish.
Yeah, and when you run the ball with the lead in the fourth quarter, and you run it well, it makes it a lot easier.
You're able to run 4 minutes off the clock.
They have a big, big lead, and they're on the move again inside the 20.
So I think we'll keep these sliders for next time. I don't know if this was like a great showcase for it, because they just have a really, 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 really good defense. This is some bullshit. I hate this. I hate this so much. So look, he's in a block. I start my fucking thing, and it literally, it brings me back. That is such bullshit, dude. That is such bullshit. Oh, my goodness. We're going to just kill it, man. That's so stupid. I'm so glad I didn't care about that play. We have some highlight or some awards to show off. Some Pro Bowl votes and a newspaper to show off, and then we will be out of here. No fumbles, no penalties. Forced 3 turnovers on defense, 1 reception by 3 different players, 5 tackles with 2 different players. Be a liability at safety. Wait, what? Why would it say that? All righty. 19 of 38, and we were 50%. 290 yards, 1 touchdown, 1 interception. Matt Forte, fucking jeez, dude. 25 carries, 80 yards. Grossman had 3 carries for 14, and Jason McKee had that other one. All right, Devin Hester, 8 catches, 134. He had a freaking day. Marty Booker had 5 catches, 71. Matt Forte had 2 catches, 61. Greg Olson, Jason McKee, Earl Bennett with nothing but 2 drops. 2 drops, my guy. Can't have that. And, oh my God, did you see, look at, what the fuck? So, Roberto Garza, number 1 on our team in pancakes. I think he, Michael Ruse, got more pancakes than the rest of my whole team. Jesus Christ, that's terrible. Earl Acker with 9 tackles. Nick Harper had 10. Ryan Fowler and Javon. Javon Curse was all over everything, man. We got sacked? I don't remember that. 4 kicks. That's a good deal. All right, let's check out some of the fun stuff. Let's check out the awards and the newspaper, and then we will be getting out of here, and I'll be uploading and making the thumbnail. Let's simulate the week, and then we'll check out what's going on around the NFL. All right, we didn't check last week. Great, it's Packer week. All right, we have 3 weeks to go over here. This was our bye week, week 8. So, Chargers beat the Saints 31-15. I believe that was in London, but I don't know. Let's see. Raiders lose to the Ravens. Oh, controller died. We have to charge this. Bills win by 14. Of course, now the controller dies. Like, thankfully it's now, but come on, man. Where's my cable? All right. Bills beat the Dolphins by 14. Chiefs lose to the Jets 21-6. Cardinals get their second win of the year. Panthers are 2-6 and they kick the shit out of us. That's one of their wins. Holy crap. All right. Anyway, Buccaneers go down to Dallas and lose. The Eagles get their fourth win of the season, go 4-3 here. Patriots beat up on the Rams, go 7-0. Washington goes to 5-3, 24-16. Afternoon slate. Jags beat the Browns. The battle of the 2004 first-round quarterbacks. Eli Manning gets the edge over Ben Roethlisberger. In the NFC West, the Niners take down the Seahawks at home. And Monday Night Football, there was no Sunday night game? What the? Okay. Monday Night Football, the Colts take down the Titans by 7. Week 9, Bills get their fifth win of the season over the Jets, winning 27-6. Let's see. Bengals get their second win, beating the Jaguars. Ravens go to 6-3, beating the Browns 23-10. Texans beat up on the Vikings 20-7. We remember we beat up on the Lions 48-10. Chiefs win in overtime over the Buccaneers. That's a Super Bowl matchup. Future Super Bowl matchup. Rams get their third win, go 14-10 in an NFC West victory. Titans win over the Packers by 6. The Broncos score a big 38 points to get their second win of the season over the Dolphins. Cowboys win the NFC East matchup in New York 20-17. Eagles win 21-12 in the Sunday afternoon game. Raiders get their second win of the season at home, win 38-10. Sunday Night Football, it's Tom Brady, it's Peyton Manning, and the Colts dominate at home, give the Patriots their first loss of the season. They won 24-6 over the Patriots. And on Monday Night Football, Steelers, Redskins, classic Super Bowl matchup. The Steelers win in overtime 26-20. And the week we just played, week 10, the Browns beat up on the Broncos at home. You saw us get the win 33-14 over those Titans. Lions bounce back and they win 17-13 over the Jaguars. Texans continue their winning ways, go 23-3 over Cincinnati. Patriots were mad. Oh. And they won 27-0. Falcons over the Saints for their Falcons fourth win of the season in an NFC South matchup. Going a little bit further into Florida there. Dolphins lose at home to the Seahawks, 27-24. NFC North matchup. Packers at the Vikings. Vikings are on the downward spiral here as they lose 31-13. The Jets get their win at home, 22-17. Panthers get their third win of the season, 24-7 over the Raiders. Steelers with a huge win, 41-17 over the Colts in the afternoon. Chargers win at home. They're 8-1. They win over the Chiefs in an AFC West matchup. Sunday Night Football. It's the NFC East. Who would have thought? The Eagles win over the Giants 38-31. And on Monday Night Football, the Cardinals get their third win of the season with a 2-point victory. All right. Now let's go ahead and check out. Let's check out the league news. And let's check out the weekly awards. So we got to check out 3 weeks here. All right. Week 8, LaDainian Tomlinson had 30 touches for 168 total yards and 3 total touchdowns. Mike Peterson got 8 tackles and an interception. So we'll check the NFC for the NFC players of the week. Jason Campbell had 205 yards passing, 2 touchdowns, and a 3-yard touchdown run. And Rocky McIntosh had 5 tackles and 2 interceptions. Going over to week 9, Matt Forte, big, big day. 28 carries, 197 yards, and a touchdown. 1 catch and a 60-yard touchdown reception. Dexter Jackson of the Bengals gets the defensive player of the week for week 9. 6 tackles, 1 interception, and a fumble recovery. And it's one of those two went for a touchdown. So in the AFC, the offensive player of the week was our boy Smokin' Jay Cutler. 299 yards, 4 touchdowns, and a 3-yard carry. And on the NFC, the defensive player of the week was Greg Ellis with 10 tackles and an interception. Oops, spoiler. Week 10 is LaDainian Tomlinson. 23 carries, 108 yards on the ground, 6 catches, 67 yards, and 3 touchdowns through the air. Willie McGinnis is the defensive player of the week. 17 tackles, 2 forced fumbles. And so on the NFC side, it is Michael the Burner Turner, who had 25 carries for 180 yards and 1 touchdown on the ground, 3 catches, 16 yards, and another touchdown through the air. And defensively, it is Chris Harris with 8 tackles and a forced fumble that he would recover. That is all of our players of the week. But we get the yearly awards. Currently, we'll just kind of go through the NFL. I won't go through each thing. So we'll just kind of go to the NFL once we get later on, then we'll go through more later. All right, MVP front runner is LaDainian Tomlinson with Peyton Manning, Ben Roethlisberger, Brian Westbrook, and Brandon Jacobs. Offensive player of the week is a lot of the same people, but our boy Matt Forte is showing up down here. Showing up. Defensive player of the year, Marlon Greenwood, Rocky McIntosh, Patrick Willis, Adelius Thomas? Yeah. And Omar Gaither, defensive player of the year. Offensive rookie of the year, Matt Forte, is shining. Why the fuck is Earl Bennett there? Why the fuck is he there? Oh, my God. Rookie Brian Brohm for the Packers? What happened to Aaron Rodgers? We're going to have to go investigate. But Joe Flacco and Matt Ryan are also there for offensive rookie of the year. Defensive, it's the coach, Gerard Mayo, Vernon Golston, Quinton Demps, Kenny Phillips, and Keith Rivers. That's all we'll kind of check out for now. Let's see if we have any pro bowlers on the NFC side. We do! Rex Grossman is the backup quarterback currently. Let's just check offensive here. So Rex Grossman is sitting there, I think because of his touchdowns, but we'll see. Devin Hester is the number one receiver. That is shocking. And Greg Olsen is number one tight end. Do we have any offensive linemen? I would be a little... John Tate, let's go. Roberto Garza is there. Josh Beekman. So it seems like our offensive line is getting... And Orlando Kurtz. Defensively, anybody here defensively? It's probably not. Ooh. We'll see. Manura's out for a while. DeMarcus Ware is there. AJ Hack is there in the luscious, luscious locks. Pat Will. London Fletcher. Carlos Rogers. Leo Shepard. Hey, we got the boys. Vasher and Tillman are there. And then nothing special teams. Deshaun Jackson and Snorris Moss. So, one last thing there is to check before we say goodbye. We got to check the news. What is going on in the NFL? Milestone kick return yards for Dante Hall. He has now piled up 10,000 kick return yards. Good job, Dante Hall. Let's check out McKenzie, who's out for the season. It is Giants right tackle Kareem McKenzie. Doesn't say what. Okay, cool. All right, let's go to the focus. Steelers report. If you get a chance, watch the Pittsburgh-San Diego game this week. Steelers are at home, so it should be a great game. Milestone fumble. Aiken Ayodele? Well, regardless of how his name is said, he has 10 career fumble recoveries at this point. Milestone for sacks. Bears out of Wadley Ogunleye has now 70 sacks on the career. And a clean bill of health. Let's check it out. Patriots, Tom Brady should be back from his injury. Brady was hurt. Is that why they lost to the Colts? Holy crap. You know what? While we're here. Oh, no. It seems like Aaron Rodgers missed some time as well. So lots of injuries, lots of injuries. Let's check the local newspaper. As we see, Ottawa Leagunlia gets the highlight. Chicago wins 33-14. Experts predicted that this game would go down to the wire due to the similarity of the two teams involved. Wasn't as close as expected, as Chicago easily won this one. I was stressed the whole time, so I wouldn't say easily. Packers face Bears. Game track. This rivalry has always been volatile. Emotions will be running high in this one. Whoever sets them aside will win. Chicago wins 28-22. That's the prediction. So, hey, look at that. Offensive rankings. Chicago Bears are currently ranked number one in passing offense. And we are currently ranked number one in total offense. All right. So, we have expectations. Oh, okay, cool. All right, so that is going to do it for this one, guys and gals. Thank you very much for joining me and our Chicago Bears. We are happy to see two more wins in the win column. Hopefully, the Sliders can make these games a little bit more competitive, so it's not so bad. But I thank you for joining. Vikings, thank you for the follow this stream. I don't know if you're lurking or just whatever, but I'm not trying to call you out. I'm just trying to say thank you. All right, recording, stream. Thank you very much. Have a good night and goodbye.